Graphic elements of your user interface can change appearance to reflect the different states they're in. For example, they may change appearance to show that they are checked, or pressed, or focused, or even some combination of that, such as both checked and pressed. If you were making a web app, you would define these states in CSS, but in Android, we use state lists. State lists are XML files that list the assets to use given a particular state of a UI element. You just give it a range of resources for the different states, and everything is taken care of for you. So here's a state list for a checkboxes drawable. It uses different images for each of the defined states. When the checkbox is just checked, it uses this image. When it's just pressed and not checked, it uses this one. And if it's both checked and your finger is pressed down on the checkbox, it should use this image. And by default, in the case where there are no special states, it just uses this default version. When using a stateless drawable for a UI element, Android traverses the selector and looks for the first item that meets the minimum criteria for the state. So if you want to use an image to represent multiple states, such as this one, pressed and checked, that should be above the more general ones. Now, the interesting thing about states is that you can even create your own. While there's things like pressed and checked and focused and selected and activated and, really a lot of different types of states, you can even create your own states to map to whatever your application needs to represent in its UI elements.